GD, that is group discussion. So group discussion is becoming one of an essential step in the hiring process and for the admission of top business schools in India and abroad. In the group discussion, along with the subject knowledge, the communication skills and teamwork, especially performance and communication in a group of people or maybe in a team of a people, is evaluated. So by the end of this video, you will learn certain do's and don'ts if you're going through a process of group discussion. Hey everyone, welcome back once again. By the end of this video, you will learn certain do's and don'ts of group discussion. Make sure to watch the video till the end, and if you have further queries, feel free to comment them in the comment section. Group discussion is an activity where a group of people are given a particular topic and they're asked to present their viewpoints. So along with the technical skills, along with the knowledge, the candidates are evaluated on the basis of their performance in the team or in the group and the communication skills along with the subject knowledge of the candidate. In the group discussion, a particular topic is given to a group of people. Generally, a group discussion is of 5 members, 15 or 20, not more than that, where each one of the member of a team is expected to express their viewpoints. I remember my first group discussion where there was a topic and I was really not prepared for the topic. In that case, you'll have to remember certain do's and don'ts. What to speak in the group discussion, what not to speak in the group discussion, and this is how this video is going to help you. We will divide this video into two parts. First, we will see do's of a group discussion, and second is don'ts of the group discussion. So let's start with the do's of the group discussion. Point number one, which you'll have to remember, is listen to the topic carefully. Because in a group discussion, a topic is given to a group of people and you'll have to talk on that. You'll have to share your thoughts, your idea, your knowledge about that topic. The topics are declared. Generally, in group discussion, the topics are given suddenly, but there may be some exceptions where the topics are given well in advance and then you'll have to come prepared well in advance and then you'll have to speak. So when in the group discussion, topics are given on the spot or just before 5 minutes or 10 minutes, then you'll have to listen to the topic carefully. Point number two you'll have to remember is noting down your points or put your thoughts on a piece of paper. Because in a group discussion, when the topics are given, multiple points will be raised by each member of the team and you'll have to be very careful what point to be presented in the group discussion. Point number three you'll have to remember is initiate the discussion if you know the topic well. But if you're not well prepared or well aware of the topic, it may happen, and that's fine. Because I still remember my first group discussion where mushrooming of hotel industry in Pune was given, and I was really not well aware of the hotel industry in Pune because I was new in the town. So it may happen that if the topic is given is new to you, then I'll suggest to you not to initiate the discussion, otherwise you'll land in the trouble. Then the question comes, if you are not aware or prepared for the topic, then what to do? There is a solution. Then listen to other people first, those who are presenting their point, and accordingly then you can frame certain views about the topic and then you can contribute something in the group discussion. Next point in the do's is do support your point with some facts and figures. So whenever you're talking, mention to some statistics. It may happen you may not have right figures in hand, so it's better not to mention them. But if you are known of the topic or if you're prepared well, if you have the correct information about the topic, then I will suggest you to put your topic with some facts and figures or some statistics that adds value. Next point under do's is make short contributions. You can restrict your contribution to 25 to 30 seconds and repeat your contribution maximum 3 to 4 times, not more than that. Give equal opportunity to all the members in the group discussion to put forward their ideas or thoughts. Next point, do speak politely and confidently, and also do respect the contribution being done by other people in the group discussion. It may happen at some point of time you may be disagree with someone's statement or viewpoint, but show that politely. And the last point you'll have to remember under do's is to summarize if the group doesn't come to a conclusion. So this will help you to summarize all the facts and figures or the viewpoints which other people have put forward in the group discussion. So this is the first part of the video. You'll have to remember these do's, but along with that, you'll also have to remember certain important don'ts when you're performing or when you're contributing something in the group discussion. So here are some don'ts for you. Point number one, don't initiate the conversation or the discussion if you're not having enough information about the topic being given for that group discussion. It's better to wait and listen to the viewpoint of other people and then start contributing. Point number second, don't overreact, don't overspeak, and don't snitch someone's point or someone's chance to contribute in the group discussion. Point number three, don't argue or don't shout in the group discussion. Point number four, don't keep continuously looking at either the evaluator or some group member, and don't make them feel uncomfortable if you're continuously looking at them. Point number five, don't talk irrelevant and divert the conversation of the group discussion. Next point, don't pose negatively, like playing with the hairs, playing the table, or maybe playing with the nose or touching the nose. These are the gestures of a negative body language, so try to avoid them in the group discussion. Next point, don't show low self-confidence, maybe with the shaky voice or trembling with the hands or with the legs. These are the signs or gestures which shows that the candidate is low in the self-confidence. Next point is, don't try to dominate the discussion or viewpoint of someone in the group discussion. And point number last, you'll have to remember, don't embarrass someone by taking their name or by asking them to speak if they don't want to. So these were some important do's and don'ts of group discussion. I'm sure you must have found this video helpful and informative. If so, then please give a thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe the channel. Also do comment and let us know certain do's and don'ts of group discussion which you think can be added. I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, this is Sandeep signing off. Thank you for your time.